Hello and welcome back to the channel. This is Abhinav. In this video, we are going to talk about the problem D2 of Codeforces Global Round 16, which is seating arrangement hard version. So I have already created a video on the easy version. So if you have not seen that video, please check out that video once, because the logic of the video is applicable in this video also. Okay, so please check that video first and then come and watch this video. Fine. So now I am going to discuss the logic behind this problem. So first of all, we discuss the problem statement, I think, here. So the problem statement of this is as similar as the first part, and the only difference is here the n is between 1 to 300, and in that problem the n was only 1. Fine. Okay, so what we have to do is, let's move towards the whiteboard to discuss the logic behind the problem. So this is yes, you can say it's a tricky problem, but the logic is just similar to that of the easy version. What we have to do is, here we have some n plus, you can say here we have some n plus 1 people. Okay, okay, so here we have some, let's take the red pen, some n into m people. Okay, and we have to put these n into m columns, which are is a matrix, you can say it is a matrix. Okay, so what you have to do is, so first of all, store these people in a vector pair. Okay, we have to store these people in a vector pair. Why in a vector pair? In which we have to store them. Okay, right here pair, I have not written vector pair of LL comma LL. And what we will store here in this is, first we will store is the value of eyesight, that is AI comma AI. So we have to store the index of that particular person and the eyesight of that particular person in a vector. Okay, now then what we will do is we have to solve this vector according to the eyesight, means the first index. So we will solve this vector. So now what we'll do is, let's take a test case to discuss. So for example, I am taking this test case, which is 1 1, no, not this, because it's just easy. So let's take this one, which is 3, 4, 4, 1, 1, 1, 5 times and then 2. Okay, so it is 3, 4, 4, 1, 5 times and 2. Okay, so I'm taking this test case. It is, let's check. It is 3, 4, 4, 1, 5 times, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 2. The value of NMM is 3 here. Okay, so now what we will do is, we will first solve these vectors with their index also. The index of this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, this is the index. Now what we will do is, we will solve these vectors. So after sorting, it will become 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, then 4. And because it is a pair, then we have the index also. The index of first one is 4, 5, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The index of 2 is 8. The index of 3 is 0. It is 1 and it is 2. These are the index. Okay. Now what we will do is, we will divide this into n parts of m length, means n parts, these are n parts because there are n rows, so we will divide into n parts. Fine. So the available n is 3 here, so we will divide into this type. So now these 3 person will sit in the first row, in the second row, and these 3 in the third row. This is what is happening here. Now what we will do is, so we will place these persons in the particular rows, and now we will solve this particular sub arrays on the basis of their indexes. So they are already solved. You can see that they are already solved. It is 3, 4 and 5, it is 6, 7, 8 and 9, it is 0, 1 and 2. Otherwise you have to solve it. Now you have to place these people in the particular seats, so that their inconvenience is minimum. And for that, you have to just apply the logic that I have applied before, which is in the easy part of the problem. that logic. This is what you have to apply. Okay, so let's take the logic that what I have told you in the last video. I have told you that the inconvenience caused by a people is the number of people with low eyesight with his before the people. The number of people which are coming before that people with a less eyesight. For example, there's no people before it, so inconvenience is zero. Okay, inconvenience zero. For this, it is also zero. For it is also zero, because there are people but the eyesight is not less than that. The now come for this sub-array. So inconvenience for this one is zero. For this one is also zero, because there is no person before one whose eyesight is less than one. And for second it will be two, because in this sub-array, in this particular sub-array, there are two persons before two whose eyesight is less than two. So the inconvenience is two. Same for three. For three in this particular, in this sub-array, for 3 the inconvenience is 0. For 4 the inconvenience is 1, because there is one person whose eyesight is less than 4 and is lying before 4, and it is also 1. The sum will be 4. 2 plus 1 plus 1, it will be 4. And this is the answer only. You can check it, the answer of this test case. The answer of test case is, the test case is the, it is a third test case, and the answer is 4. This is what we have to do. I hope you understand what I'm trying to say. Now move towards the code part. So code is also very simple. So I have first created a function solve. In this solve function, I have inputted a pair, vector pair, in which I am making the same logic which I have discussed in the last video, in the first part of this video, that if the eyesight is low and is coming before, then we have to increment C++. And what I am doing, I am just dividing this whole vector into n parts. You can say it n parts of m length before sorting this vector, and then finding the C of each and every part. Okay, and here also I am sorting this on the basis of their second index, means the second value of pair, because it is the index. So this is my code, my logic. So I hope you understand what I am trying to say. If you have any doubt, then you can comment it down, or you can also join a Telegram and you can ask your doubt there. You can subscribe to our channel for competitive programming content. Thank you for watching the video. I hope you like it. Please share it with your friends. Share, like, share, subscribe. Thank you for watching. Thank you.